side of us.
Traffic signals in the city.
And from this room, we control the operation of almost half.
First thing you do when you try to time a traffic signal is you look at how wide the streets are so you can provide enough time for pedestrians to safely cross the street. And from that, after that calculation is made, you determine the vehicular volumes on the different approaches and attempt to time the signal to accommodate the traffic volumes. And that may change by time of day or day of week. And we use a 3 foot per second crossing speed, which is below the national standard, which provides for ample time for people to safely cross. Cycle length is the amount of time it takes for the signal to totally cycle, to go through all of its different phases. Each phase, for instance, is a predominantly most streets are two phases, where you have one direction moves, then they stop, then the other direction moves. That's a two-phase signal. A three-phase signal may incorporate a left turn arrow in one of the directions. Cams and dials and shafts that mechanically change the light signals themselves. Over the past few years, we've updated to an advanced solid-state traffic controller, which is basically a computer, to run the traffic signals, and we found this to be much more reliable and with significant reductions in maintenance costs. With the signals that we're communicating with, we can monitor their operations via the traffic management center. For those that are not under computer control, we rely on the public via 311 to call and complain to their operation, or we have inspectors who go out periodically to observe their conditions and make sure they're functioning correctly. Eventually, our goal is to have all the signals under control from this room, so if a signal happens to malfunction, we'll know immediately.